Hello and good day, welcome to our YouTube channel God's Promises, and to this video will be a fast concise overview. Book of Exodus, chapter 3. Let's get started now. The Book of Exodus, chapter 3, is a pivotal chapter in the Bible, as it records the famous encounter between Moses and the burning bush. This encounter marks the beginning of Moses' journey as the leader of the Israelites, and contains many important lessons and teachings for us today. The chapter begins with Moses tending to his father-in-law's flock in the wilderness of Midian, where he encounters the burning bush. As he approaches the bush, he hears a voice calling out to him, saying, "Moses, Moses." He responds, "Here I am," and the voice identifies itself as the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. God instructs Moses to take off his sandals, for he is standing on holy ground. The chapter goes on to record God's commissioning of Moses to lead the Israelites out of slavery in Egypt. God tells Moses that he has heard the cries of his people and has come down to rescue them from their oppression. He tells Moses that he has chosen him to be the one to go to Pharaoh and demand that he release the Israelites. From this account, there are several important lessons and teachings that we can learn. First, we learn that God is a God who hears the cries of his people and is concerned for their welfare. The Israelites had been suffering in slavery for many years, and God had not forgotten them. He was aware of their suffering and was determined to do something about it. This teaches us that no matter what situation we find ourselves in, we can trust that God sees us and cares for us, and is working for our good. Second, we learn that God often chooses unlikely people to carry out his plans and purposes. Moses was not a natural leader, nor was he eager to take on this task. In fact, he tried to make excuses to God, saying that he was not a good speaker and that the Israelites would not listen to him. But God assured him that he would be with him and would give him the words to say. This teaches us that God can use us, no matter our weaknesses or limitations, to accomplish great things for his kingdom. Third, we learn that obedience to God often requires humility and submission. When Moses encountered the burning bush, he was in the wilderness, far from the centers of power and influence. Yet God chose him to go to Pharaoh and demand the release of the Israelites, a task that would require him to confront the most powerful ruler of the time. Moses had to trust in God's strength and guidance, and be willing to submit to his will, even when it was difficult. Fourth, we learn that God is a God of holiness and requires reverence and respect. When Moses approached the burning bush, he was instructed to take off his sandals, for he was standing on holy ground. This teaches us that we should approach God with humility and respect, recognizing his holiness and our own worthiness. It also teaches us to take seriously the call to holiness in our own lives, and to strive to live in a way that honors God. Fifth, we learn that God is a God of compassion and mercy. He had heard the cries of the Israelites and was moved to act on their behalf. He chose Moses to be his instrument of deliverance, and promised to be with him every step of the way. This teaches us that God is not indifferent to our suffering, but is actively working to bring about our deliverance and salvation. Sixth, we learn that God is a God of power and might. He demonstrated his power to Moses through the burning bush, and promised to perform signs and wonders to convince Pharaoh to release the Israelites. This teaches us that we can trust in God's power and might to overcome any challenge we face. No matter how great the obstacle, we can trust that God is able to overcome it and bring about his purposes. Seventh, we learn that God reveals himself to us in a variety of ways. In this chapter, God reveals himself to Moses through the burning bush. This was a miraculous and unexpected way for God to reveal himself, but it served to get Moses' attention and convince him of the reality of God's presence. God can reveal himself to us in many different ways, through the natural world, through other people, through scripture, and through the working of his spirit within us. Finally, we learn that God desires a relationship with us throughout this chapter. God speaks to Moses personally and intimately. He reveals his character and his plans, and invites Moses to participate in his work. This teaches us that God is not a distant and impersonal deity, but a loving father who desires to be in relationship with us. He invites us to come to him, to know him, and to participate in his work in the world. In terms of practical applications, the story of Moses and the burning bush teaches us many lessons that we can apply to our daily lives. For example, it reminds us to trust in God's care and provision, even in difficult times. It encourages us to be obedient to God's call on our lives, even when it requires humility and sacrifice. It challenges us to approach God with reverence and respect, recognizing his holiness and our own worthiness. And it inspires us to seek a deeper relationship with God, through prayer, worship, and the study of Scripture. Overall, the story of Moses and the burning bush is a powerful reminder of God's presence, power, and love. It teaches us important lessons about obedience, humility, reverence, and trust, and encourages us to seek a deeper relationship with God in our daily lives. As we reflect on this chapter and apply its teachings to our lives, may we be inspired to follow God more closely and to serve Him more faithfully. Knowing that He is with us always. Por favor, compartilhe conosco seu capítulo bíblico favorito, abaixo na seção de comentários. Não se esqueça de curtir e se inscrever, isso realmente ajuda nosso canal a crescer. Espero vê-lo de volta aqui para o nosso próximo vídeo. Cuide-se sempre bem!